In today's video, we will be connecting the 18th century philosopher George Berkeley, immaterialism, and the movie The Matrix. Without a doubt, the movie is a goldmine of philosophical ideas, and is probably why it is still often referenced even to this day. But in this video, we will be focusing on our boy, George. Let's begin. In 1685, close to Kilkenny, Ireland, he holds a vast record of schooling, spending several years at Kilkenny College before entering Trinity College, located in Dublin at the young age of 15. It was during his time at Trinity College where he was exposed to the relatively modern new science and philosophy of the late 17th century. It was during this time that Berkeley would form his own ideas of immaterialism in contrast to other philosophers at that time, such as Hobbes, Locke, Descartes, and many others. He spent his life in many academic institutions and even traveled to Europe for 4 years before visiting America for a while. He died in 1753 while residing in Oxford, England, supervising his son, George's education. While Berkeley contemplated and wrote on many philosophical ideas, he is most remembered for his writing on immaterialism. He is quite critical of materialism, which is essentially the opposite, and he does not believe that objects can exist out of the perception of humans. He famously coined the phrase, "To be is to be perceived." To Berkeley, materialism promoted skepticism, because materialism implied that our senses mislead us, and atheism, because a material world could be expected to run without the assistance of God, which he did not believe was possible. His primary argument for his own belief is that we perceive objects such as an apple, glass, pencil, through our own senses and ideas. Therefore, these objects' existence are arbitrary to our mind. This is immaterialism. Now let's discuss The Matrix. The Matrix is a film set in a dystopian future where humans are unknowingly trapped in a simulation created by artificial intelligence in order to keep them imprisoned. The simulation, where people are living in the modern world, exactly as our own, and is the reality to all who inhabit it, except for a few who deep down feel that something is not quite right. The main character in the movie, Neo, is one of these people, and is contacted by the humans who have escaped the simulation. When he meets the leader named Morpheus, he tells him that he is right to feel as if something is not as it seems. He says, "What you know, you can't explain, but you feel it." Neo feels it in the same sense as intuition, that there is something more to reality. Morpheus then says, "You are a slave born into bondage, a prison you cannot smell, taste, or touch." In other words, Neo is imprisoned, but he cannot see this reality because he cannot perceive it, just as Berkeley believed. Morpheus then offers Neo a choice between a red pill and a blue pill. If he chooses the blue pill, then he can stay in the reality that has been predetermined for him to live. This would be ignorance for bliss. If he takes the red pill, then he will learn the truth and the true reality. When Neo took the red pill, he is transported out of the simulation, which he now knows as the Matrix, and into his physical body. All around him are pods that house all the other humans that are currently experiencing the same simulation. He is saved and taken back to the base of the human resistance. It is here where he is trained and learns the full extent of the reality outside the simulation. Morpheus tells him that he believes Neo is the chosen one to destroy the Matrix and set humans free. Neo is taken back into the simulation to meet with the Oracle, who supposedly will reveal his fate. When he gets there, he encounters a little girl that appears to bend a spoon with her mind. He is intrigued and goes up to her. She gives him a spoon and says, "Do not try to bend the spoon. That's impossible. Instead, only try to realize the truth. There is no spoon. Then you'll see that it is not the spoon that bends, it is only yourself." We see Neo not physically bend the spoon with his hands, but rather by accepting a reality in his mind, perceiving it as bending. This directly parallels Berkeley when arguing that ordinary objects, such as a spoon, are ideas that can be changed, bent, unbent. So if we were to ask the question whether or not The Matrix is a legitimate take on a philosophical idea that relates directly to George Berkeley, the answer is yes. The Matrix is a great contemporary way to express older philosophical ideas Creating contemporary representations of philosophical subjects can increase interest and understanding of what may be difficult to understand from the modern perspective. And many of the concepts in the movie can directly be compared to Berkeley, such as the truth existing in your mind, and objects are what you perceive them as. I am a firm believer that a contemporary representation of a deep philosophy such as immaterialism is easier for people to understand because it is presenting an old idea from a modern, familiar lens. I hope you found this video valuable in your philosophical journey. Till next time.